The E1 reaction competes with SN1 and SN2, or excuse me, E1, SN1, and E2. There we go. It's favored by an ionizing solvent. And a weak nucleophile and base. It can be favored over SN1 by using a little heat for the reaction, because if our alkenes are lower in energy than our final product, we can get to the most stable product over time, so possibly due to reversibility over SN1 by heat. Also, mechanistically, the E1 reaction begins the same way that the SN1 reaction does. So if we consider this system, where we have beta hydrogens here and here, we favor the Zaitsev product . Okay, so if we have an ionizing solvent, we can ionize same way as SN1. So here we are at the carbocation intermediate. We want to form the most stable alkene . So we want more substituted. So the beta elimination from this beta hydrogen, or one of these two, is favored. And so we take our weak base, weak nucleophile. Remember, SN1's in competition here, but we can take our solvent, grab one of those beta hydrogens, the bond from the sigma bond becomes a pi bond, quenches the carbocation, and we form the most stable cation. And E1 elimination is not like E2, and that it doesn't require the anti-periplanar relationship of the beta hydrogen to the leaving group. So you're always going to pick the major product is the sterically most stable. And that's the case for E2 if there are multiple beta hydrogens. But, for example, we would want, if the steric cloud looks like this for an alkene, we would want the most stable versus, say, a relationship where the big groups sterically are on the same side. Okay? And that does not necessarily mean E versus Z. That's just the size of the group's electron clouds bumping with torsional strain. You want to avoid that, and that's especially preferred with E1. E2 prefers big groups on opposite sides.